I think it's pretty much common knowledge that, you know, video games based off films are largely terrible. They always seem to be rushed, poorly developed, and just lacking any semblance of quality control. Then you've got games based off other things, like the game Cool Spot based off 7-Up Soda, Nerf Arena Blast serving as a digital marketing campaign for Nerf guns, and then lastly you got a game like Chex Quest, created as a video game promotion for the Chex cereal brand. This was a game that was given away in Czech cereal boxes in certain countries back in 1996, and it was for the most part little more than a total conversion for Doom, developed by a team called Digital Cafes and running on the same engine, offering up new weapons, enemies, and levels. On premise alone, something like this should be inherently bad. However, the most astonishing part about all of this was that Czech's Quest is actually pretty damn good. So the story goes that you play a Czech warrior who is up against an evil alien race named the Phlemoids. Phlemoids are basically walking boogers that fling their slime at you and function largely the same as the Doom enemies they replace. The most basic Phlemoids are grunts that replace the zombie marines from Doom, and they are generally the least threat despite being the most abundant. Then you've got the Phlemoids in armored suits that throw their slime at you from a distance, replacing the imps. And lastly, Phlemoids that float around in these little bubbles, attacking you at close range, functioning the same as Doom's demons. The later episodes also have enemies that replace the Barons of Hell and Cacodemon respectively, and also other variants of the imps and demons. So all in all, it's a pretty good lineup, and they're all animated very well, showing off a surprisingly high amount of detail. Likewise, the weapons are entirely the same as Doom, so you've got your pistol, shotgun, chain gun, rocket launcher, plasma gun, and BFG. All of the weapons are given some name derivative of the word Zorcha, you know, Zorching device, Zorch propulsor, etc. If all of this is sounding a bit silly at the moment, that's because it is. But the thing that all kind of stops it from being unbearable is that it's built upon one of the most iconic and timeless shooting mechanics of all time. You could mod absolutely anything into the Doom engine and it would still be tolerable in some regard, simply because the controls, movement speeds, and aforementioned shooting mechanics really are that good and easy to pick up. As I said before, it largely does just feel like a total conversion for Doom, though instead of 9 levels per episode, you only get 3 episodes and 5 levels apiece. Now, it's hard for me to talk too much about the history of this game because I don't think this promotion ever saw the light of day in Australia, but as far as my research has taken me, it seems that the game was originally broken up into 2 separate episodes. Episode 1 takes place on the planet Bezoik and has you rescue your Czech warrior comrades from the caverns beneath the planet's surface. Episode 2 is set in Czechstopolis and has you moving through some very well crafted urban environments like cinemas, museums, and the city streets. And then lastly, Episode 3, which was only released in 2008, I might add, kind of mixes different environments together for the series' official conclusion. You've got a sort of United Nations-style complex, Mexican-themed villa, and a large forest-type area before the game's conclusion on the Phlemoid mothership. These are generally what you'd expect from mid-90s level design, so you'd be running around fairly complex levels, picking up key cards to open different doors, before activating a button on the wall to finish the level. And they are, for the most part, very well designed, with some intricate and thoughtful layouts and interesting architecture. It's sort of quintessential FPS level design and a testament to what the gameplay used to be like back then. Compared to Doom, though, Czech's Quest isn't nearly as violent. I mean, you'll be taking on dozens of Phlemoids in a single encounter, but when you kill someone, they just kind of evaporate and vanish entirely. There's no blood or guts or anything like that. It really is a much more family-friendly version of Doom in that regard, which isn't a bad thing, but just don't expect to see Phlemoids get ripped to pieces when they catch a rocket from your Zorch propulsor. Looking for things to complain about with this game, it's kind of hard. Anything I could come up with is negated by the fact that this is a free, readily available game. I mean, I guess you could complain about its length. Even when you finish all 3 episodes, you're probably only looking at 1 to 2 hours game time max. But like I said again, this is a free game given away in cereal boxes, and you kind of have to keep that in mind. The level design is well thought out, the combat is suitably challenging if played on the highest difficulty, which it really should be. And it's got lots of that 90s DOS gaming charm with the various sound effects and MIDI tracks for each level. I also find it enjoyable playing through the original Doom with this mod activated. It's not Simpsons Doom fun, but it's still good to play. Getting this game up and running on modern systems is an absolute breeze thanks to the awesome Z Doom engine. which requires you to do nothing more than just dragging the WAD file into the same folder as your ZDoom executable and double-clicking. Some of the games I mentioned a bit earlier in my review, you know, Nerf Arena Blast and even Cool Spot to an extent, are largely just worth checking out for novelty value. But Chex Quest is actually not a bad little title. At least, it's as good as it's going to get for a game based around a guy made out of cereal fighting intergalactic snot monsters.